Hey guys, Mike McSmurphy here, and welcome back to another Warframe video. Today I have a special Warframe here. Well, not really special, she's a bit old to Warframe now, but yeah, Zephyr Prime. And I also got Vauban, but I will make a video on him later on. But now it's gonna be on Zephyr Prime, and she's quite an awesome Warframe. She's basically a bird frame, but except for the flying like Titania, she glides away and is super fast with some of her abilities I'll show you now. But yeah, let's just first get into the build. So first, this is my main build. Went with Rejuvenation as the aura mod. You can format that and change it to whatever you want, maybe put in physique. Yeah, right, so when I get damaged I can easily replenish my energy. Stretch to negate narrow-minded for the duration. Prime continuity for duration with constitution as well. And then prime flow for energy. You can, if you want to, just spam her abilities, but you don't have to. And then vitality for the extra health if you go up against infested or what. You can change that also with primed vigor, whatever. You can change it with primed vigor to balance out your health with your shields, but yeah, I don't know, I just like it to have lots of health. And then streamlined for efficiency, of course. Yeah, the first ability is basically just you, if you move and you look forward with your crosshair in any direction, you basically launch yourself in that direction. If you hold it in and release it, you'll boost yourself upwards and hover for a duration. And also the distance you travel with just tapping it is affected with duration mods. You can also go for a little bit damage when you like dive bomb down. You look down and activate it, but it doesn't do that much. The second ability is just like crowd control to blow away enemies or to make your tornadoes bigger, which we'll get into now with the fourth. Also, it's you can increase the range with range mods. Turbulence is basically a defensive ability, like a windshield around you. And if you have the shield radius at least, I want to say about 5 meters or 6 meters, you can't take damage except for those bombards. They can somehow the bullets just ricochet against the wall and bounces over it and falls on you. You can die, but if it's above that, it's fine. That's why we have stretch on. And then the tornadoes, you have 4 tornadoes, which also has a certain amount of duration with duration mods. You can increase the radius with your second ability just to make it a little bit bigger, but with range mods like stretch or auger reach. Yes, and her passive is just you fall slower than any other Warframe, so you can stay up in the air a long time. If you want to, you can put on aviator so that you take less damage when you're in the air, but if you have your third ability on at all times, it's fine. Let me show you some color schemes I found that works nice. So this, we went like the main color is bright, and then the secondary and tertiary is black. I don't know, it just looks nice with the Zephyr Prime. The accents, I like it to look, make it look more primey. What's so shiny now? Yes, the wings and everything. And then I went for the opposite direction with config A. The primary and secondary is black, and then tertiary is white, and still the accents is this orange. Yeah, we're just gonna do like 30-minute survival and also get some relics. So far, yeah, Zephyr Prime is a decent Warframe. She doesn't have any like healing or overpowered abilities or like a king in Aros, but that's why she's the bird Warframe, sort of speaking. But yeah, so far she's a really fun Warframe. If you want to go on like open world missions like the Plains of Eidolon or Orbis Vallis, she's gonna be real fun to like maneuver around and just crowd control people. It's awesome. So yeah, that's all I have for this, and if you guys enjoyed it, please like the video and subscribe for more videos, because I'm gonna be bringing out another Warframe videos soon. Yeah, and I'll check you guys in the next video. Peace. We are here.